Just doing a quick little tutorial about how to use the Tumna Fruit Glitch when, well, everything goes wrong. This is not only a dead-end room where nothing else can escape. I have no holy bell, which would make this extremely simple. So when this immediately happened, I picked up Queenie. So just use the Tumna Fruit onto Queenie. It turns him into a frog, but this also opens up the tile beneath me, so I act like a tile which has no space. Now, unfortunately, there's kind of two things you can do here. One is you can beg Queenie. You can call her. Also, if you were to pick up Queenie and just select return and return him back to your home, it would have the same effect as the Tumna Fruit, but you don't get to keep Queenie. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to just wait until Queenie turns back. And this is going to be a very boring video, but this is just kind of to show you what you can do when situations like this happen. I'm just doing a practice for the Rock Me to the Top tournament right now, and yeah, this is kind of annoying. Also, all the trolls here are not level 1. When they're coming in from a monster den, they get spawned in with hammers. So these are basically the troll bowgun level trolls with the wrong weapons. Which is annoying because actually I could make use of the fact that they have, what's it called? I could make use of the fact that they have the troll bowgun and they try to shoot me in a line and weaken up the other monsters. But we're just gonna do this for a while and, excuse me, and take advantage of the fact that honestly, we can't die. But I don't want Queenie to stay as a frog because my whole goal is to get to the elevator, and then after I get to the elevator, you know, we're golden kind of thing. But I don't want to have to take Queenie out and then go up to floor 12 and have him stay as a frog and then not have mixture magic at my disposal. So I'd much rather take a time loss here, and it's already been like 2 minutes, but surviving in the speedrun is more important than getting a PB at times, especially in race format. And unfortunately, this is going to take a while. Like, the other option is basically, like, I have a stream wand on me, which so gives me the kind of weakness to the volcanoes and trolls here, and griffins, I guess. The dreamers not so much, but they're not really going to be doing much. And we are just going to start waiting on them. But this is the Tumna Fruit glitch in a nutshell on why, honestly, I prefer Tumna Fruit over a Holy Bell. So there we go. So now we don't have to worry about that anymore. So now we can beg him, or call her. Goes back into the bag, and now, so these five monsters around me have very little MP. I'm gonna actually focus on the troll first, just because they have a little bit less HP, and I kind of want the griffin to take its place. And I think in 5 turns it should possibly be able to. Yeah, there we go. Now it looks like it's gonna be another troll that walks in. Oh, volcano. Also, you can technically pick up and throw. This is not gonna do a lot of damage at all. So this is honestly, I don't know how to speed up the emulator, or else I would speed it up. But it's also good to show it in real time. Also, my microphone should be working now compared to previous ones. Apparently when I was cleaning, I bumped the back of it and turned it down to basically zero on the back of the blue yeti. Okay, so is this gonna be the griffin now? Good. So I want the griffin to stay there, and I'll start taking out the dreamin'. Okay, so there's a chance the griffin might use rise. And obviously, like, with 49 HP, I'm gonna get hit for about 13 apiece if I were to move off this tile. There's no way in the world I can make it to the next couple tiles to the side there. Actually, I should focus on the volcanoes, truthfully. Or switch my weapons. Big difference if you have the wrong type of wand. That's my bad. I forgot I had a stream wand equipped. So normally, like, you can't really bank on too many monsters. Come on, other griffin. There we go. Because honestly, the griffins are the scarier bits, but they're also the non-wind creatures. So I could switch back to the stream wand, actually, thinking of it. But I've done a couple of videos before of, using it and doing whatever, or I've always talked about it in races or commentary or any percent runs. And honestly, like, the other option as well. Yeah, here we go. A natural troll came here. So that's the annoying thing. He kind of wandered in the room, but he's going to weaken up that one volcano there, which is nice. Wow, I'm just getting all the misses right now. So, I was really hoping that the griffin would actually try to chant Rise, but seemingly not. That's okay. Let me try to pick you up and throw you over that way. Alright. It's not going to make a difference. They're gonna, by the time I do anything, they're going to wander out. But... again, this is why I would probably want to have a lot of the trolls with the bow guns here, because they would all start trying to shoot me and weaken up each other. This is like, if a monster den happens, like, honestly, the game is straight up trying to kill you. There's not really many ways out of it. I'm honestly surprised a troll could shoot around the volcano's butt. Prime commentary here. I should be weak enough now to... yeah. So something else will take its place. There we go. So more or less the goal is that you want to get all the monsters from the side away. Him on that side. Nope. I should probably take out that volcano so it opens up a slot here. Here we go. See, that's what I was waiting for. They have the chance of doing that every turn. We'll try to get rid of this guy, because there should be one or two more hits after this. We're gonna put the volcano there. So now we've basically cleaned off this side of the room. We want to pick him up. That's fine, as long as it doesn't try to put us asleep. And there we go. That's how you kind of deal with monster rooms and stuff like that with horrible odds. And then once we're here and once we renew our save, we take out Queenie. Queenie hasn't wasted any MP, and then we can explore the next floor. So it's I was just doing, again, practice, and I figured, hey, this would be a decent little tutorial to kind of show how to maneuver. It's really important that you know the monster's abilities, the monster's movement, like if it's a bunch of pickets. That kind of sucks, sorry. Glaciers, you're screwed, because if they shoot their, glacier at you, you actually get pushed out of your immortality. They're one of the very few enemies that can do that. And then, if they have long range stuff like either Troll Bowgun or Fire Magic or whatever, you can use that. And honestly, like, it's always good to keep a neutral base weapon in your inventory if you're on the kind of the wrong floors or you don't have Queenie to support you. Sometimes monster dens only like four monsters and they're kind of laughable. And with some decent movement or a holy scroll, you can get out of it. But as you can see, the entire floor room, where the room was basically red, and it just got really, really bad. So anyway, that's it. That's this tutorial. I don't know if I'll upload this or not, but if I do, hey, you're watching it. But thanks for watching. Hope you have a good time, good day, whatever. And yeah, see you later.